हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, और टुडे विल कंटिन्यू द लेसन 6, दैट इज द कंप्यूटर नेटवर्किंग। सो इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट द नेटवर्क कंपोनेंट्स, सो दैट इज अबाउट द सर्वर, अबाउट द क्लाइंट, अबाउट द एनआईसी कार्ड एंड अबाउट द मोड ऑफ कनेक्शन, मॉडेम एंड द हब एंड द स्विच। सो टुडे we'll study about the repeater and the router. See, that is the repeater and the router. So this repeater is also a communication device, and it is used to regenerate a signal. Sometimes what most of the times you can see, suppose we have to communicate from Basti to Delhi. So between Basti to Delhi there is a long distance, and that long distance is around you can say 700 kilometers. So in that distance 700 kilometer, our signals, that is our voice signal, which is generated at the end of Basti, if it travel to the 700 kilometer distance, so what will happen? Our signals after 10 kilometer or 5 kilometer, it becomes weak, and it becomes so weak that it cannot, that energy can travel to Delhi with the same strength. So what is needed? So at every tower, that's our signals travel from one tower to the other tower, and every tower there is a device that is called the repeater, and this repeater receives that signal and regenerates the signals. So it amplifies the strength of the signal. So it receives the electronic signals, cleans them, means it removes the noise, and also retransmits them from one tower to the other tower, from and the nearest tower, whatever the tower will be there, to that nearest tower it will be transferred. So these signals tend to distort when transmitted over long distances. So repeaters are needed so that the signals can travel longer distances with the same strength or even at a higher power. So what do we need here? These signals tend to distort when transmitted over the long distance. Yes, signals becomes weak. Distort means weak. And repeaters are needed so that the signals can travel longer distances with the same strength or even at a higher power. Next is the router. This router is a communication device, and it is also used to connect two different networks such as LAN or WAN. And this also plays a vital role in controlling the traffic and keeping the network efficient. It chooses the best route for the data packets to be transmitted at the receiver's end. So router is also placed over the network, and the purpose of this router, it is an intelligent device, and what it does, it make a record of the shortest path. Suppose your packet is transmitted with the help of the different towers, with the help of the towers, and maybe that towers came across the source end and to the destination end. Between that tower, it will select the that path where there will be the less number of towers is needed. That is the shortest path it will take. So a router will make a record of the shortest path. So next time when the packets will arrive, so that packet will be sent to the same route. So that is the work of the router. And it plays a vital role in controlling the traffic also. And suppose the traffic is too much busy, so what it will does? It will hold the packet, and it will wait for some time for the clearance of the channel. And keeping the network efficient, it chooses the best route for the data packets to be transmitted at the receiver's end. And so what is the best route? The best route will be the shortest path. So that is the work of the router. Next, you can see this figure 6.1, this is the router, and figure 6.10, you can see this is a repeater. Next is the gateway. Gateway is also a network point, and it also acts as an entrance to another network using different protocols. So suppose if you want to have a communication, if you want to send a signal from one network to the other network, from one protocol to the other protocol, suppose if you want to establish a communication from mobile network to the telephone network, that is the PSTN network, public switch telephone network. So to transfer the signal from one protocol to the other protocol from mobile to PSTN, we need a gateway. So that is the devices are needed, and thereby giving us a freedom and convenience to enjoy online. So what a gateway is, a network point that acts as an entrance to another network using different protocols, thereby giving us freedom and convenience to enjoy online. It allows us to carry out various online activities such as sending email, browsing through web pages, buying things online, and more. It is a shared connection between a local area network and a larger system. That is the WAN. It basically works as the messenger agent that takes the data from one system, interprets it, and transfers it to another system. It is also called a packet converter. So, with the help of this gateway, we are possible to send the mail. It helps us to browse through the different web pages. It helps us to buy the things online, and it is a shared connection between the LAN and the larger system. That is the WAN. So basically, what it does, it works as a messenger, it works as an agent, and it takes the data from one system, interprets it, it takes data from one network and interprets it and transfers it to the another network, another system. It's called the packet converter. It converts one packet in one form to the other form. Now, next is the bridge. Bridges are repeater. Bridge is also a repeater with add-on functionality of filtering content. Regenerated the signal also, and additional to that, it also has the functionality of filtering the content by reading the address. So it filters the content also, it filters the data also by reading the address of the source and destination. As you can see this figure, this is the bridge. So over the bridge, different networks are connected. Four networks are connected. So whenever the data will come, it will filter it also. It will regenerate the signal, and additionally it will filter the data also. So it is used to interconnect two LANs working on the same protocol. So yes, bridge is only used to connect the two LANs which have the same protocol. If suppose both are connected with optical fiber cable, the same network, then can be done. But it cannot be created like a computer is also connected and the telephone is also connected, means another different network. Both have the same protocol. So it is used to interconnect two LANs working on the same protocol and provides the communication between them. It also prevents unnecessary traffic from entering the network and reduces the congestion. Yes, it prevents the unnecessary traffic because it filters the content. If suppose unnecessary requests are coming, so they will abort that request. They will not accept that request. They will prevent it. And they will reduce the network congestion also. Okay, so now after that is the transmission medium, and this transmission medium is the mode through which the data are transferred, from where the data are carried. So this data can be transmitted from one location to another by using wires or without the use of wires. Means data is transmitted from one place to the other place, from one computer to the other computer. Sometimes it use the wire, LAN cable, or sometimes it is transmitted wirelessly without wires. So this transmission medium is divided into two categories: guided media, that is the wired media, and unguided media, that is the wireless media. Guided media, first wired media is the Ethernet cable. As you can see, this is the Ethernet cable. So an Ethernet cable is the most popular form of network cable used in the wired networks. And this cable resembles a phone cable. It is just looks like a phone cable. It is larger than the phone cable and it has 8 wires. Here it will find the 8 wires. Here you can see that the 8 wires are there. So Ethernet cables connect various devices. It is used to connect the PC's, personal computer, routers and switches within a local area network. Yes, switches are also connected with this Ethernet cable. The advantage of this cable is that they have less power consumption, but the drawback with this cable is that the computer requires an Ethernet adapter card is needed on the motherboard. If Ethernet adapter card is not there, so you cannot connect it. So yes, it needed the Ethernet adapter card on the motherboard to connect the Ethernet cable. And these cables have their limitations also, both in the distance and they can stretch and their durability. So this is the Ethernet cable. So which So this is all for today, students. So in the next class, we'll study about the some other guided media, that is the optical fiber cable and other cables are there. So this is all for today. Thank you for your attention.